pit where you can turn in, drag you some soil and learn in. He found that he was earning freedom from his fears. But by the coal fires burning, he found his stomach churning, for his mind it kept returning back through life's unlocking. The dusty books upon the shelves, the golden bell wearing deep mind down into the corners of ourselves, where no voice can be heard. He buried his head and he set his mask, and he struggled to rise up to the task. Goodbyes the borrowers who came to ask upon the written words. He returned to the mines till another chance came, but a porter's work was not the same. So another bridge burned, but who could blame this blindless, restless bird? As the wheels of life kept turning, the chances he kept spurning, his heart was ever yearning to be back where he might belong. For he'd grown more discerning, but all matters concerning what keeps the pages turning through the circle of life's song. I've gazed upon the wonders of mountains and lakes, marvelled at the designs of stars and snowflakes, delighted in wandering by farms and by streams, scrambled up hills where sunlight streams, and I've pondered the mysteries of a life beyond. To many questions I felt the need to respond. I've been vocal in social circles with men, retrieving a solitude with me books and me pen. Onward now to Shakespeare's aboard, from this humble man for a heavy lord, for the patronage and the favours owed, for a life that did not suit. A poet's paradise for sure, but for the pause he had to endure, even the god held no allure for one who could not take root. He listens to his inner harp, his gifted mind was shrewd and sharp, his instinct led past cliff and scar, not for him the easy route. As the carriage wheels kept turning towards the home fires burning, and for all his years of learning, he found he had no fear. Chances he was learning, not the bridges he